in the land of grills, folks. Yes, we've got the Ninja Woodfire Outdoor Oven, folks. This thing is so cool. I've been waiting for a while to get this, and it finally came, and I had to share it with you right away. This thing not only is an oven, not only a pizza oven gets hot, but you can also go low and slow on this, and you can do a lot more than just pizza in there while adding wood smoke all at the same time. Pretty interesting. We're going to show you what we paid for it, and we're going to show you all the dimensions, how it works. We're going to make a pizza in it too. Let's get started. And folks, if these Ninja Woodfire products are interesting, I also have the Ninja Woodfire grill, and this thing too gives the opportunity to add smoke to whatever you're cooking. And this thing, where I did pizza on this one, so I'll leave a link down below. Don't forget to check out Tom Horstman at YouTube. And if you want to support the channel, don't forget there's that super thanks down below. Buy me a cool drink. Let's take a closer look at the Ninja Woodfire oven. All right, so one of the most common questions is, how does it get the smoke in there? So with both these, with the Ninja Woodfire oven and the Woodfire grill, is that you've got this right here. This moves, this is stainless steel, and you put pellets in there. You put pellets like this in there. And when you buy this, it does come with a small bag of pellets, and it doesn't really take that many. And you just fill that up. When you put it on the, you can choose to go with wood or not with wood, but when you press the wood fire button, then it preheats this and gets the smoke rolling throughout the chamber there. So you can choose to add smoke or not add smoke. All right, let's talk about dimensions here. The width in the front is about 17 inches. Its height to the top of the handle is about 15, and its depth, now it's got a bump out in the back for there's a fan housing. So you need to, right to the edge of the handle here, is about 22 inches. All right, common question, can you use this in the house? Now, Ninja designs this like the Woodfire grill to be used outdoors, folks. You're probably asking, what can this thing all do? So let's just look at the controls here. It's got a warm, dehydrate, smoker, bake, broil, specialty roast, max roast, and pizza. And when you go into the pizza setting, there's for all different Napoleon type, artisan type, thick crust, pan style. They even got a setting for, and I'm gonna be trying it, frozen pizza. Imagine putting a little smoke on a frozen pizza. That sounds interesting. All right, you're saying enough of this, Tom. Tell us what you paid for it. So there it is, ninjakitchen.com. I did look on Amazon. This is not on Amazon yet, but they talk about brick oven inspired textures. And like I said, this is more than just pizza, and we'll get into that. High heat roaster, artisan pizza maker, barbecue smoker, 8 functions, temps up to, like I said, you know, and there's what I paid for it, $400. Okay, keep on going. All right, so what do you all get for $400? Obviously, you get the cooker itself. You get a little bag of pellets. Funny thing is, the pellets weren't in a box, and all of a sudden I got a FedEx delivery of just this little bag of pellets. So that was interesting. You get all the directions, quick start guide, and everything like that. You get the stone for making pizza there. You get this pan. There's a lot of weight to this pan. Now this is the roasting pan. So if you, like I said, I want to try, I don't think I've said this yet, but I want to try doing like a chuck roast on here, low and slow, with some smoke in there, and see how it turns out, something like this. I think that would be interesting. Ribs, you could do ribs in here. You could actually try a pork butt in here, and maybe it's just a little small brisket flat. Yeah, all that is possible in here. And you know what? Let's keep on going, talking about all the other things we can do with this wood fire oven from Ninja. All right, so on the inside, they've got a nice gasket here. It's kind of like an oven gasket. There's going to be a lot of people who are going to say, Tom, this is like an oven. And so the door handle is it's a little difficult here, but I think they do that on purpose here. It like locks right there, and then you got to give it an extra oomph to get it open. Everything is nice polished stainless steel on the inside. You've got it pulls open like this, and it has a stop right there. And there's your pizza stone. You would take this off, and you could put that in there. And then I was also planning on, hang on, let me show you. Even though they do sell a cast iron accessory, this thing right here, I'll leave the link down below, is very inexpensive. This does fit on there. And this could be one of the first things that I try, doing some cast iron steak on this thing. A little bit of smoke in it. That would be interesting. Let's keep on. All right, the inside nice and shiny, just the way I like it. That thing right there looks like a temp probe. So I think that's what's telling the whole thing what the temp is on the inside. You can see we've got this open enough. This can also go, there's a second level here for that to go on. And then if you're wondering if there's anything up on top, You can see there's heating elements up there, and then there's a fan in the back to move everything around. All right, so if you're wondering what the pizza stone dimensions are, it's basically, it's 12 1/4 by 12 1/2, so 12 by 12. So the basting pan fits in just like that, and you can pull it out much like you would in an oven, and then the whole thing lifts out just like that. All right, so Ninja gives you a pretty good description of what everything does here on the control panel. They are telling you cannot use the wood fire technology with broil or warm functions. And you know, if you're wondering, is there, they do have a table available for this. You go there and it's got a side table on it. I'll leave the link down below to the stainless steel roller that I have here that is very affordable from our good friends over at Vivor. All right, here's some of the pizza instructions. Don't want to smoke, don't put pellets in. And if people are gonna ask, can you add more pellets? And my past experience says, yes, you can. But there's something important here that you need to see is that the preheat can take 8 to 25 minutes. Now, I did a burn-in on this thing already, and it was all 20 minutes to get it to, and I had it set at 600 degrees. And we're gonna do that again, get it up to 600 degrees, and then when I'm ready to make my pizza, that's when I'm gonna put my pellets in, get the smoke going, and we'll see how that turns out. Let's get started with that. All right, so I am gonna pour some pellets in, and just like that. And remember, you can add, the nice thing about this is that smoke starts, stops, you're gonna add this and open this up and put more in. It only takes so much, and then it'll ash over and you won't be able to put any more, but I think you can do it at least once or twice. All right, let's get it started. We're gonna take, you got an off button here, we're gonna take it and put it to pizza, and you see it says 700. We are going to take our temp though. We're actually going to take our, here we go. So you can do Napoleon, thin, New York, pan. I hope you can see all this. Roaster, and then custom. And that's what I'm going to do is custom. And I'm going to adjust my temp and just use this. And I'm going to take it to 600 because I, in my opinion, pizza's good at 600. And then we're just going to press start. It's going to preheat. Now, you can wait on pressing this pre-fire, this wood fire option, but because it's gonna take probably 20 minutes to get up to 600 degrees, although this is probably still a little warm from when I did the burn-in. So we'll see how long it takes, and then we'll get our pizza ready, and then we'll press our wood fire so we can get some smoke in our pizza. Somebody's gonna ask about the color. I don't know if this is, I like burnt orange, but I think this is more terracotta. All right, so I'm reading the instructions as I go here, and it looks like I had to put that little auxiliary, the accessory frame in, and then the stone on top of it, so I have already done that. Interesting. Yeah, and obviously there's a whole bunch of safety things here you need to look. You know, a lot of people are gonna say, can I use this on my balcony in my apartment? In apartment, you gotta consult your lease to make sure you can use it, but there's no open flame with this. So it is electrically operated you gotta take a look at your lease, or if you're in a condo association, take a look at your condo association rules to make sure that you can use something like this. And remember, it's only for outdoor use. I think if there is one criticism, the preheat mode, it is all, they say 8 to 25 minutes, folks. It's more on the 25 side. All right, that was a solid 20 minutes, and it's telling me to go ahead and press start and add food, but I wanna take a temp of the stone. So let's just see how the stone's doing. Set at 600, that's pretty accurate. That temp probe right underneath the stove, folks, is the way to go. We're gonna close this up. I'm gonna hit wood fire here. Hopefully that'll start up and get our stuff going. All right, got up to temp. Then what I did was I turned it off, went back to pizza, went through the whole thing again, then pressed the wood fire flavor, and it's now gonna start the ignition on it. And now I'm gonna go make that pizza. And by the time I come back out here, I'm pretty confident that we'll have smoke rolling here and everything should be firing up. All right, so I don't know if I'm cheating the system here. You're learning with me here. So on the wood fire grill, a lot of times, by the time we're ready to cook, the pellets are already burned up. So what I decided to do in this case was preheat 600 degrees, turn the grill off, turn it back on, and then fire up the wood fire flavor to start igniting those pellets, and that's what it's doing right now. And we'll see how long that takes. I think this is going to be faster than, because in my opinion, everything would be, you know, burned up by the time you're ready to put on at 600 degrees for pizza, at least.
All right, just so show you here, when igniting the pellets, you get this thing right here. It says ing, which means ignite, and then the little flame thing is pulsing. And I don't know if you can see that, but we've got definitely smoke rolling.
See, that's why you can't use it indoors.
All right, there's our dough. I've got a pizza peel that's 12 by 12, and that's perfect. Got my dough on there, and I'm going to put a little bit of this classical, and then a little bit of cheese, pepperoni. Show you when it's on the
ninja. All right, smoke's still rolling. You can see it coming out of there. Got our pizza. Put it on there. Give you a look-see.
All right, I forgot to press start. That just starts the timer.
You see the smoke coming out like that. I'm not sure how long to go here. There's no window. So, you know, we just started here, and we're going to probably go down to 7 minutes, take a quick look at it.
All right, coming up on 3 minutes with smoke at 600 degrees.
Yeah, look at that. I'm probably going to go just another minute or two and give it a look-see. All right, lots of good smoke coming off this thing. We're 1 minute more. I just want to take it out and you can see all the smoke there. And just see, I'm assuming this is going to be warmer toward the back than it is the front. So we're just going to give it a turn like that. Put it back in for another minute or so. Take a look at the bottom. So far, so good. First pizza. That's impressive that it's turning out this good.
And then obviously the smoke production is pretty impressive.
All right, let's take a look-see. I think we're done. Look at that. Nice looking pizza. Oh, it's hot. Take a look at the bottom once we get it plated up, folks. Pretty nice putting it in.
All right, there it is. First pizza.
I'll tell you what. Crust could have been a little bit better, but it still got a little bark to it. And the top is good. Let's take a taste test. Oh, man.
All right, first thing that hit me was the smoke.
Yeah, so if you're looking for wood-fired, the Ninja, I tell you what, even on the Ninja grill, one of the things that shocked me the most was just a couple pellets, and it ain't much. A handful of pellets will give you a smoky taste. And that's what I did here on the Ninja wood-fired oven. Tom Horseman, YouTube. Thumbs up, leave a comment, and as always, appreciate you watching. Thank you.